Which TV show got too big for its boots?
Prison Break. They kept having to break out of prison every two seasons.
Game of Thrones. It arguably crashed under the weight of its numerous plot lines, poor direction, and self-imposed time restraints. HBO would have thrown them all the money they needed to make as many seasons as they needed and the story deserved, and showrunners said no.
Once Upon a Time, interesting concept, poor execution down the line.
Fairly Odd Parents. The writers were fine, but Nickelodeon got too greedy. The addition of Sparky the dog, the new neighbor girl, and the whole anti-fairy world subplot was too much. They just kept adding stuff, but the original structure was pretty good to begin with.
The Walking Dead. Amazing comic, brilliant first few seasons, but they strayed way too far from the comics and ultimately dragged it out much longer than they needed to. Edit, holy beep guys, I went to bed and woke up to 8k upvotes and 2 awards, thank you everyone.
Is it fair to say Heroes? I love the show, but it was whack for like the last 2 seasons. The reboot was just I don't know what that was.
Weeds. Once she left the burbs, the whole premise was lost and beep went off the rails.
That 70s show after Jackie and Hyde broke up, Eric and Kelso left, and Donna became blonde. WTF.
Arrow. By like the 3rd season, everyone and their mom becomes a superhero.
I loved True Blood, but man, it went way off the rails, especially the last couple seasons.
For me, it was Orange is the New Black. When it started out, it was a fantastic show. It had a diverse cast, a perfect blend of genuinely funny moments mixed with the hard-hitting, brutal reality of prison, a realistic portrayal of both the prisoners and the staff, and a genuinely compelling story. With all of the praise they received, the creators got into their heads that their show would become a huge vehicle for change and was providing a voice for the voiceless. But in the pursuit of that goal, they ended up doing away with the other important stuff that made them good. They replaced most of the prison staff with one-dimensional brutes and cliched, mustache-twirling villains, like Donuts, Piscatella, Thomas Humphrey, Hellman and Linda Ferguson, added a few equally one-dimensional, brutish villains, like Madison Murphy and the Denning sisters, amongst the prisoners, and just sacrificed their entire plot. By the end, it was nothing more than just injustice porn.
Dora the Explorer was always held back by its beep boots.
I want to say Dexter, but honestly I don't remember how it ends. Something about that dumb girlfriend, something about it was not very Dexter-like. Edit, so I guess I really did forget the ending because I have no recollection of the lumberjack mumbo jumbo.
13 Reason Why It Really Should Have Stopped at S1. It couldn't make up its mind what it wanted to be anymore. Like, it started as a cautionary tale, but then a ghost story, then a clue murder mystery whodunit, it just got too out of whack.
Not a TV show, but the Despicable Me franchise. The first movie was actually really good and funny, and the second one was actually pretty good also. Everything after that felt like one big Minion toy advertisement.
Two come to mind, Glee. The first 13 episodes are good, then somewhere in the second half of the season they started taking themselves too serious. It would have been much better as a one-season show. Heroes, please someone tell me I'm not the only one to remember what a global phenomenon Heroes was touted as. They had their own silly magazine and a worldwide launch party for seasons 2 and 3, but while season 2 could have been decent if it had actually been given time to develop, both seasons were nothing but a mess.
Shameless, I grew up in a rough neighborhood with a drunk dad. Then they just sorta kept pushing the characters back to where they were and not really letting them evolve. Not to mention Debbie.
Grey's Anatomy, it's currently on its 18th season. Almost all of the original cast is gone. I still watch it, but it's not very good anymore.
The Flash CW, I really liked season 1. Great cast, great writing, and helluva a lot of great moments. Season 2? Not bad, but a repeat of season 1, then they just kept repeating the trope of evil speedster, and then making the characters dumb. I also got tired of the many different Wellses.
House of Cards, US version. Season 1 was amazing, season 2 got a little wacky, and the rest was garbage. Storylines just completely abandoned. I didn't even watch the last season for various reasons.
The Simpsons. It started as a skewing of the mainstream, became the mainstream, and is now a repetitive parody of itself.
Cannot believe asterisk lost asterisk isn't mentioned yet. It's the most obvious one to me. They were literally forced by the network to make more seasons than they had plot for, and you can tell. The first few seasons are so damn good and interesting, but then it just becomes mystery after mystery with few, no answers in sight.
A lot of people are bringing up shows that just turned to beep, happens to many or most, but when I hear, too big for its boots, I think of a show that blew up and collapsed under the pressure of popularity. By that definition, I would say True Detective. The first season, in many people's opinion, is among the best single seasons of TV, ever. Its creator and writer, Nick Pizzolatto, whether in a self-imposed rush or pressured by HBO so they could ride the wave longer, pumped out the second season the next year, which was absolute dog beep. I begrudgingly watched the entire season thinking it had to get better, but it didn't. They took a few years to reset for the third season, but I'm too jaded to want to watch it.
Supernatural, after Lucifer, they just kept raising the stakes and eventually had to fight God himself.
The recent Sherlock series with Benedict Cumberbatch. I loved S1 and liked S2, and then it went off the rails.
Nip/tuck for me. Man. First three seasons were just fantastic. After that, just went for shock and trash.
The Big Bang Theory seemed like it was desperate for new episode ideas in the end, and the same jokes were wearing thin.
The Walking Dead. Utter drivel.
SpongeBob, it's not even SpongeBob anymore. I don't even call the new seasons proper episodes. You can see a clear barrier when Hillenburg died and when Nickelodeon took over and disrespected his death and legacy. I can't even watch Nickelodeon anymore, it's not even Nickelodeon, they changed so much. They ended up like mobile, where everything is just 2-minute produced ads to farm money from games with no effort put into them. Children's television is much less in favor than before, they stopped trying, they just laid down and died. They can just produce garbage and reruns and make money, so they did. Just like mobile and movies, nowadays everyone just watches old movies and shows, back when they had passion.
Homeland. It was meant to be a single season miniseries, but the network loved it so much they forced them to rewrite the ending of season 1 so the story wouldn't end. Same with Westworld. Season 1 is beat brilliant and the ending perfect. Was no reason to continue the story.
People worship The Office, but it went on for too long. The last couple of seasons felt unnecessary and pointless. The show should have ended when Michael left.
Pretty Little Liars, How I Met Your Mother, Glee.
BBC's Merlin. It was a good series, but they did the whole Morgana turns evil way too quick, then it was mostly fighting her for the last two series and it really got old. They kept having the whole they defeated her in a way not even a magical person would survive, like crushing her to death or something daft, but she comes back, then right at the end they just stabbed her, she fell from camera view, and that was that. It was such a rubbish end. Also, Game of Thrones. The shop I work in sells game, TV and film merch, and we got Game of Thrones collectibles when it was still popular. Now we are stuck with stock we can't shift because the show deflated like a lead balloon and nobody wants stuff anymore.
The Blacklist. I love James Spades, but first had to stop watching. Edit, Spader asterisk.
Grey's Anatomy. Once Christina left and Patrick Dempsey was killed off, they just stopped trying. I stopped watching after Alex beat up what's his name in season 0.13. IDEC.
2.5 Men. That series was a juggernaut up until Charlie died, left, sacked. They thought they could keep pushing forward with Ashton Kutcher while failing to realize Charlie made that show. It wouldn't have been anywhere near as popular without Charlie and his banter with John Cryer. Those two played well together.
The Minions. The characters and the concept itself was great, and I still find them funny in their own, annoying way, but they got so stupidly squeezed and overused for the sake of profits. Not to mention that somehow they also became a gold mine for the boomer Facebook memes.
How I Met Your Mother. Went on for WAAAAAY too long.
May your day be filled with joy and happiness. And please remember to like, share, and subscribe for more quality content every day.